This is Alex, the driving instructor from Sensen Driving School. In today's video, we will be going into part three of our general driving in the Point Grey area. So this video starts off exactly where we left off in part two. We were waiting to turn left as car number two, and the light had turned yellow, so car number one went, and because we are car number two, we wait behind the first white line until the next light. So while we wait at a red, it doesn't mean we stop driving. We definitely want to be looking around, checking for pedestrians. You're checking for what's around you. Are there any cars behind you? Any cars beside you? So with this left turn, normally we'd be, when the light turns green, we creep out and put our shoulders on top of the third line, or where we position where we're sitting on top of the third line, and we wait for oncoming vehicles. But at this particular one, we received a advanced green arrow, which means that we have right of way and we could proceed without waiting. So as soon as the light turned green here, it was the green arrow. So I did my shoulder check and hand over hand steering and letting the wheel spin back. So this Mercedes in front of us is waiting to turn left. No, we did not go around him. No, we didn't change lanes. We just waited patiently. It's the same story here. The vehicle in front of us is waiting to turn left. Our intention is to go straight here, but we will still wait patiently behind this vehicle. So once the light turned green, he rolled forward, and as vehicle number two, we wait behind the first white line, as if it's like a red light. As this vehicle turned, there was still a lot of time left on the light, so when it was safe, I proceeded forward, of course scanning the intersection. Keep hugging that yellow line, keep scanning the intersections, keep checking your mirrors every 5 to 8 seconds. So you can see here, I didn't want to block the alleyway, so I left a little bit of space between us and the vehicle in front. As we all know, we cannot block intersections. As we proceed through this intersection, I noticed the right lane ends, and so I did a right shoulder check just to see who was beside me, who was going to try to merge in front of me or behind me. And luckily no one was beside, so it was clear to go. Still scanning those intersections, still checking the mirrors every 5 to 8 seconds, and still hugging the yellow line. Hugging the yellow line on a road like this is beneficial because it helps protect you against the doors that could swing open from parked cars on the right hand side, if any. Pedestrians jumping onto the road, cyclists being beside you. Same story here, I didn't want to block the alleyway, so I stopped a little further back. So this upcoming intersection is a little tricky. It's the boulevard left turn. And instead of your normal left turn where when it's green, you line up your shoulders or placing where you're sitting on top of the third line, there's a different waiting position. So let's see me do this in real time and I'll talk you through it. So that's the left turn signal. So with left turns, I only need one shoulder check, and it's before you turn. So as you can see, it's still red light, so of course we're waiting behind the first white line. Okay, it's green, so we inch forward and we roll into the middle of the boulevard, keeping the steering wheel straight, of course. You're watching for oncoming vehicles, pedestrians crossing the street on the left, and the traffic light. So that's me checking my left side there for pedestrians, waiting for them to cross, and there was an oncoming vehicle, so of course I waited. And I did my one left shoulder check to double check for any additional pedestrians, and then I turned hand over hand, letting the wheel spin back. Of course, watching for pedestrians and hovering my foot over the brake for 2 seconds as I approach crosswalks. Aha! This is why we do it. My paid actor showed up right on time. And we waited for the pedestrian to cross 100% before we proceeded. Up ahead here, we end up turning left. And because there's the boulevard on the left-hand side here, we turn into the boulevard on the right-hand side. And notice how as soon as I get in there, I try to straighten out my wheel. So this is so I don't lose track of my steering wheel. I know exactly where it is. I waited for a safe gap from the cars coming from the right, and when it was safe, I proceeded. Okay, you see that 30 sign on the right-hand side? Playground zone. Did you guys see the sign on the right hand side there? So it's the same idea with school zones in terms of where it begins and where it ends. You're looking for the front of the sign on the right hand side, and it has to state 30 kilometers an hour for you to go 30 kilometers an hour max. And you are looking for the back of the same sign on the other side of the road to know where it ends. So that's a picture of that there. When you're driving through a school or playground zone, you can expect speed bumps. And for speed bumps, I recommend 20 kilometers an hour or below, or 15 kilometers is ideal. There's another speed bump. So even though the playground just ended, it's still 30 kilometers an hour down this street because it's a bike path. Or a bike route. Reminding drivers to be careful, of course. So we're approaching a two-way stop here. That was the first stop. That's the second stop. And when it's safe, I proceeded. Okay, right turn, that was my first shoulder check. My second shoulder check and turn. Okay, I believe we pull over here. That was my shoulder check for the pullover. So pulling over parking, we will definitely be visiting this in future videos. That's the end for now. Please subscribe, like this video, and comment below, and let me know what you would like to see more from this channel. Thank you very much. Until next time.